Hello, Internet. James Allen from Out of 8, and today I'm playing turn-based strategy game Conquest of Elysium 4. This is the latest in the series by the developer of the Dominion series. This is intended as a more approachable, faster game, and we'll take a look at what the improvements are since version 3, which I actually reviewed when it was released. Game features both local and online multiplayer, either against bots or against human opponents. The network games, you have to set up an online game server to do that. So we'll just start a new game here. You can select a map size. I'll just do medium. Select the society and advanced options like that, like usual in these types of games here. A lot of options here. And then you select the players. For each player, you can select one of the classes here. Basically, the classes influence what type of units and spells you have access to and which resources you have to collect on the map. I usually pick random out of here, but I think I'm going to just pick one of the more spell related ones. Actually, I've done the witch before. That one's pretty interesting. And then I'm going to keep all the other people at random. You can also adjust the difficulty level. So I'll put a couple of these guys up a little bit harder than they are. And then you press OK, and it randomly generates a new map. Has a new generation engine since the last version of the game, which creates more plausible maps instead of just being completely random stuff. So let's see what we get. Pick a name, Elsa. Alright, that's a pretty terrible start. Pretty much the biggest problem with Conquest of Elysium 3 was that the game world was entirely too hostile when you start out. There's way too many enemy units that were way too strong, and you couldn't afford enough troops to take them over, so you'd routinely die within the first, like, 10 turns of the game. Now, I'm happy to report that for Conquest of Elysium 4, this has, for the most part, been eliminated. There are still lots of units, like, for example, this port has 14 pretty substantial units, so I will not attack that, but they won't come out and try to attack my tower that I have over here. A lot of the creeps that are around here are like single units or like tigers, a single fire ant, stuff like that. So it's not a lot of units. You can see here it's one captain and two halberders, which I can easily take using my units. So really that was my biggest issue with the previous game, and I'm glad to see that they fixed it. Now, every once in a while you get up against this really powerful beast that'll just eliminate you, and that's kind of part of the game. The game kind of plays kind of like a roguelike with, you know, random map generation, stuff like that, and you never know really what you're going to encounter. And some of it is luck and getting a good thing, but you can usually carve out a pretty good portion of the map without having to restart the game over and over again. You can see the interface is basically the same as it was before. There's a couple of improvements to make it look a little cleaner, but it does take some getting used to. When you select units, you actually right-click on them on the map to see them, and then you can right-click again to see what they look like on the battlefield. So the first thing I'm going to do is transfer units over to my main expeditionary force. I have some archers here, and I'm going to kind of pick that. This is not a great starting army, to be honest, for this person, but they do have a lot of spells, which is going to help me out a lot. And you can see over here your resources. You get gold from capturing villages. You can see if I capture this coastal hamlet, I'll get 2 gold. You get iron by capturing mines. You need iron in order to recruit higher level units like these cavalries right here. You also have trade, where you can, once you get enough trade points, you can sell or buy resources in exchange for gold or vice versa. And then that's basically it there. You can transfer units by clicking on them here in this display, and each wizard and magic type units have special spells and rituals that they can spend resources on. Like this person uses fungi, so I could do a minor summoning once I get 15 fungi, which will give me some ghost warriors or whatever. And then it's all different based on what your person is, you know. And as you saw in the selection screen, there's a lot of people to choose from. So let's get started. We'll capture this coastal hamlet first, and I'll probably capture this too, and then that'll be the end of my turn. Once you enter battle, then that's the end of it there. So I'll end my turn and attack the independents. Now this is, and I'll pause it before I talk, this is the new battle engine, and it's a lot more detailed and a lot better. You're still not influencing the battle in any way whatsoever. It's all automated. There's no formations either like there is in the Dominion series, so it's really kind of intended just to kind of show a resolution of the battle. You can let it play out in, you know, regular motion, or I usually speed it up after a while. But you can see all the different spells and stuff that your people will cast, so I'm going to win this pretty easily. So my cavalry takes out that guy. And all my spells. So that was pretty good right there. The fire ant took my camlet. Now, a lot of my memories of the previous game were... I need to take that next, I guess. You know, losing your starting citadel to, you know, like four deer. And that doesn't happen in this game, this version of the game, thankfully. So the early game is basically kind of exploring and expanding out. I can get one for 52. That's not good. Not good enough, anyway. I could... Tigers, though. 1 to 7, 1 to 4. That's what I got. 1 to 4, 1 to 10. I mean, I could probably take them. I don't know if it's worth it just for 2 gold and 1 fungus. Probably explore a little bit more, because they're not going to attack me too much, and I can get gold from a lot of those places pretty easily. I'm going to have to keep an eye on these tigers here. I'll probably take them out. If they're guarding a village, they'll just stay there, which is kind of nice, but if they're not, then they'll kind of roam around. So you see, I have a lot of villages and an iron mine around me, so this is actually in a port. It's actually a pretty good starting position once I get enough gold to be able to recruit some additional units. So hopefully these tigers will go down pretty quick. And they're doing some funky spells. Ugh, those tigers took out pretty much my entire army. So what I'm going to do is basically explore and take easy villages. I could take that too next turn. Maybe. Shoot. Hope I don't lose. Man, it's only 2 people. Should be able to get them before they even come in range, yeah. Alright, so... there's a town I can get later. Nope, I can't actually afford a unit. If I wait 2 more turns, I can get an archer. What do I have now? Yeah, like all my friends are dead. Actually, I don't even know if I want to do that. Probably just get the spearmen. And then that's in your... wherever you recruit them, which is usually your home, but there's other places you can capture. They have a little crown that you can recruit people from. But you have to have a leader in order to take them out from their location. So they're basically just going to guard there in case, you know, these little... people get saucy and start attacking me. So I'm going to explore. I don't care about the slinger. Ooh, I'm right next to Red. Hello, Red. And Red left me alone. That's good. Get another ward. 2 crows. Ooh. You did not defend your iron mine. But he's going to attack me. I just took my other city back. Well, I got really close to this red guy then. 10 units, which is not good. So I'm gonna... Now I can recruit some... I don't know if he's gonna be available next time. Let me see what... Because usually they're only these special people are only there for 1. Actually, I'd like to recruit him. Let's see if he's there next turn. Again, he's fine leaving me alone, thankfully. The AI, I don't know if they benefit from some sort of economic bonus, but they always seem to get way more units than I'm able to get. I'm going to attack these crows. Oh, he's still there. Okay, good. This crow should be fairly easy. Maybe. Yeah, I have like no units left. Oh, crap. Well, I'm dead. That's the end of this game.
Cool.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. So I'm just gonna die, to be honest. Hey guys, what's up? Yep. So here's what the map looked like. I was right next to red. Purple was there, and you can see all the little neutral guys. That was actually kind of a lot of people for that small map. Alright, let's do a new one. Same deal, same. Let's do a large map. And I'll just have it pick random this time, since you kind of saw what the, you know, the spells are. Let's have a piss boy. And Burgmeister. Harold the Burgmeister. You do have special powers. You can create a village once you get 10 enchanted weeds. So that's cool. Alright, let's see what we got here. Oh, a lot of units. Take, these are probably archers, huh? Yeah, crossbows. Take most of those. I'll take most of those, and I'll take most of those, and I'll take you. Alright, let's head out. This looks like a little bit less of a hostile start, I must say. Although I'm right next to all this dang desert, should have gone north. That's right. I can get this guy, so I will. Alright, let's go this way. Autumn is here. Different seasons have different weather. 6 units. And that has that crown on it, so I can recruit units. I don't know if I want to end my game already. Let me wait a little. Well, can't really wait. Let's go to the forest, I guess. I'd really like to have like another set of units before I attack that. Ugh, this is a terrible start. Okay, that's good. So I got a horticulturalist now. Oh wait, no, that was the wrong one. I want you in there. Must have been here. Yep. I need more units though. Need to wait like one more turn. Well, in that case, I'll go back here and then we'll pick them up next turn. I'd like to get that guard tower. Although, this is a really... this is actually really terrible. Okay, so let's see, what can we get? We can only get militia or slingers. Because I don't have any iron. Alright, so let's get you... and most of you guys. Alright. Let's move it. Ugh. And it's winter now, too. Alright. See what happens. Now they're in the castle, but... I think I got numbers here. Yeah, it should be alright. I like the little castle things, because you have to, like, break down the castle walls, or the, you know, the drawbridge, and then storm it after that. So now I own that, and it gives me some sight range at least, and some extra recruiting locations. And I got an eye on this giant mantis in the desert, so I'll attack him, and I'm gonna avoid that. So it shouldn't take too long. Bye, mantis. Oh, crap. Alright, well, we'll see. This is probably not going to end very well. Yeah, I'm pretty much screwed. Ugh, stupid giants. Yeah. Cool. Yep. Alright, we'll try one more. I was far away from everybody, too. I was just in the wrong spot. Yeah, that was terrible. All right, we'll do one more. It is better, I swear. Even though I've died twice. Seven. We'll do random again. Sure. At least I get different people every time. Steve. Two levees, bandits, coal mine, farms. Not terrible. We'll do that, I think. Alright. Take that. Hello. Ooh. Goodbye. There's some pretty cool spells in here. TBH. Take that. Okay. This mantis scares me. Take him out. The only thing you have to worry about with those things is just like the. Sometimes you need to just leave a couple units behind in important areas because you'll have like a fire ant come around and just take all your stuff, and then your economy will be ruined and you'll wonder why. It's because, you know, all your stuff is stolen. Alright, let's see if we can find some more free gold around here. There's one down here. Okay, we can do that. And I don't think we'll do that yet, though. Yeah, I'll definitely do that. That's a good one. Hopefully we'll survive this. Should be alright with two spell people. I found that the best kind of strategy when you're starting out is to not split up and just have one unit, but then once you start to afford more stuff, then you can take these two heroes and kind of scout more areas. Alright, so we can do a swordsman. What do we have? Yeah, we have. I should probably want a crossbowman, to be honest. If I can afford it, which I can. I'll take that. Fairy circle. Yeah. Market village, I'll give me some trade. So we will trade. We're going to buy iron every turn. So that's going to... I'll spend one gold to get one extra iron every turn, so that'll be really nice. Take that. I actually didn't see how many... it's actually probably more than I should have done. There's those three deer. Oh dear. Alright, well, hopefully this won't kill me. Oh, crap. That's what I get for not checking before I did it. And I'm gonna lose, aren't I? I'm an excellent player. Oh, man. There's a lot of space between me and the next guy, too. A lot of villages. That's what I get for not checking... what it was before I did it. Alright, well. One more. Always one more. This is one of those one more turn type games. Doesn't matter. And I'm Priest King this time. Raul, the Priest King. Alright, we got some... really? Cool. Alright, so this guy uses sacrifices and slaves for their army. So, let's pick you up. Let's get all but a couple of you guys. Let's hunt for slaves. One. That's really crappy. And that's my turn. Well, I think the boars and then four wolves captured my farm. I think these guys are stuck in the ancient forest, so hopefully they will leave me alone. Okay, that was easy. Four goblins, let's take them out. There's a town. There's a village, I'll do that village next. That was easy. These units are actually pretty good. Take that, and then we'll take that next. Let's see, how much do I need to do stuff? I need 20. What does this do? I can get a jaguar for 25. Can be cast anywhere. I might do that. Uses your entire turn, but hopefully I'll survive long enough to try it out. I think I'm actually in pretty good shape this time. Beginning units are fairly decent. Take that. And I got that farm, and then we got that village. I should probably go get that village next. Incinerate, I would say so. Alright, I think I'm going to hunt for slaves. And I'm going to stick those slaves and leave them here. Just as an FYI when I die. Okay, those wolves are wandering around. Let's see, I can do this. There we go, so I got whatever the heck that thing is. There we go, capture that. We'll scout some more. I'll take that, thank you very much. Ooh, I will not do that. No, sir. Oh, I can recruit some units. What can we get? 1-5, 1-4. So these are better, but you get 5 instead of 6 or 7. Yeah, we'll do that. You can only recruit. Oh, you're getting all up in that, Mr. Flying Guy. Ugh, I really don't want to take them. They're going to take my village if I don't. Yeah, that guy died. Still gonna win this, though. The problem is you don't really get, like, anything from taking care of these creeps other than them just leaving you alone. Oh, there's a free village. Oh, man, there's tons of villages around here. Five more units, I'd do it. There's no reason to right now. Three action points. Oh, I can afford more stuff. Let's do jungle, and then we'll do a jaguar next turn. Yep, somebody lost. Somebody invaded their last town. Oh, I do actually have trade, don't I? Let's buy an iron. Ooh. Yes, I believe I will do that. There's a little kraken. Kind of going in a circle, I would say, and then circle back and pick up some more units. I'm going to take these villages. I usually just watch them all and fast forward, as you can tell. Okay. I think I'm going to come like up and around. Oop. Got some friends. Yeah, I can take 7 levies. Yeah, there's him. I'll take that market village and then come back. Oh, hello. There's another guy. units. Well, that's disgusting. Please don't kill me. Yeah, he's taking my crap. How many units are there? 11? Can I find more units? Take him out. And he's taking some of my stuff, jerkface. Gonna find more units. Yeah. Stop attacking my slaves. Turkey. I actually kind of want to attack him. 1-7 though. That's kind of strong. I don't want to chance it. Let's take these ants out. Oh, do I want another leader or not? What is this? Sure. Go away, ants. Ugh, those are strong. That was not fun. Stop taking my stuff! Alright. Let's basically take everything except for, like, dead units. Some random assortment of units. Alright, let's go take all this crap back. I can do some nifty spells, I think. Hey, you're gonna lose some units. Die. Is that their leader? Might. I don't know. I think it's a hero, though. That went well. Yeah, I just took him out. Just that one unit, though. And here comes yellow. I'll go meet him. How many do you have? 33? That's way too many. Mostly soulless, though. Soulless are not anything. Again, I feel better if I have more units. So I think I might pick up those feathered warriors on the way. Taking him out. Take that back, though. Hey, what's up? Yeah, let's do that. Ooh, yeah, buddy. Now I'll take you on. Yeah! Here, kitty kitty. Alright, let's see what happens here. Go fast. I hope this goes well. I think this is like his army too. Oh, it looks pretty close. I think that's like the dude. A giant cat. Oh yeah, we're doing good now. All he has is like undead stuff. Yeah. Here comes my cat! Yeah! That wasn't even him either, that was like one of his subunits. I like that spell. How much was that? That was 125. Let's do another one of those. Yeah, that was dumb. That was a waste. I don't want that crap. Can recruit units now, though. Moon Warriors, huh? Yeah, we'll do that. Alright, this game, we're doing pretty good. Hey, 35 units. That's where his main guys are. I'm not taking that. I will go take your coal mine, though. Come on and attack me. Oh, no, he's leaving me alone. I'll take that. No, there's yellow. These guys are annoying as crap. Give me my stuff back. Another crazy army over there. 35. I don't want to attack you. Not without more units. This is better. It's probably why they cost iron. Ugh, dude. And of course it's winter now, so I can't move. And these people are annoying as crap. Give me my cities back. This is why you have to defend your stuff, but I don't have enough units yet to do it. I can take 10 units out. Hey guys, what's up? Yeah, I got a big tiger looking thing. He's gonna eat your face. Cool. Here comes yellow. Alright, welp. Keep losing stuff. Here comes another guy. I lost my mind. I got some deer. That's right, because I got a bunch of units. Find out in my review. Ooh. Way over there, though? That's not useful. These guys. Taking my stuff. Alright, well, I can do this again. I like that a lot. Oh yeah, look at that. I like that. Alright, let's head back to our main village and pick up the rest of these units I've been building. Yeah, there's 50 units. I bet there are. I want basically everybody. Except for like a couple guys. Alright, we should be good now. Let's go hunt. These two jerk faces keep stealing all my stuff. Yeah, I got 43 now. So annoying. Oh my gosh, look at that. Thank you. don't know about... I think I'll be alright. Most of these are dead people anyway. Right? Yeah. You can see how detailed the damage is. You know, like, uses a lot of random rolls to determine damage, but it is pretty, you know, detailed stuff. And it was pretty interesting to watch. Now that the presentation has improved since the last version. And you're dead, dude. I don't think that was him, though. No, that was one of his things. Alright, well, there you go. That gives you a pretty good idea about it. It's definitely improved since Conquest of Elysium 3. So if you like that game, this is something I would heartily recommend. The main problem I had with the previous version of the game was it was way too hard starting out. And even though my first three attempts are not very illustrative of it, it is easier to get going in Conquest of Elysium 4 compared to previous games. The environmental stuff is not as hostile as it was before, which is definitely a good thing. And that was really kind of the big problem before, was just trying to get enough units so you can actually go out and afford more units. And here you can see most of these villages were pretty easily taken, you know, minus them swapping back and forth because they didn't defend any of them against the enemy. But, you know, that basically solves the big problem from the previous version of the game. So if you like, you know, Dominions is a little bit too complex or overbearing, and you want kind of more of a roguelike experience, and this is something I would recommend. I really like the randomized maps. The generation engine does a really good job creating plausible terrain to go over. It has lots of different classes, which really kind of changes, you know, the way that you handle the game and the different resources you collect and spells you can do and, you know, what type of structures you go after on the map. You know, the battles are visually improved. You know, before it was on a plain black background and looked kind of bad. You still don't have any interaction with what happens, but it is more interesting to look at as all the spells get cast and all the units die. And the AI is a pretty good opponent too, which you can also go online and do that sort of thing. So it is a game that I recommend. It's clearly better than the previous version of the game. You do still have some early game difficulties to overcome, but once you get past that phase, you have a pretty compelling turn-based strategy game. That's all I have for today. Until next time, bye now.